गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द ऑनलाइन सीरीज लेक्चर्स ऑफ एनालॉग कम्युनिकेशंस। आई एम के श्रीकांत फ्रॉम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम ISL इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ECE। नाउ वील कंटिन्यू विथ आवर डिस्कशन एज वॉट वी आर डिस्कस्ड फ्रॉम द कॉन्सेप्ट वॉट वी डिस्कस्ड प्रीवियसली। So what is our discussion, what we discussed previously is how do we perform the analog communications. So analog communication is normally performed to transfer a low frequency signal over long distances. In order to communicate signal to longer distances, we are employing the analog communications. It is something like a human being going to a longer distance via a vehicle, maybe a bus, maybe a train, or maybe an airplane. So that means similar to that, we are normally going to communicate a low frequency signal to the high frequency signal. So at last to transmit a signal frequency, what is that we are doing? We are performing an operation called modulation. After modulation, what is happening? The low frequency signal is simply converted into a high frequency signal. So after we get a high frequency signal, that high frequency signal is radiated using a transmitting antenna via the radio channel. Now that means we have to compulsorily going to have various ranges of frequencies used to perform or to perform various applications. Now what are the various ranges of frequencies really comes under the electromagnetic wave spectrum. So what do you mean by electromagnetic wave? Electromagnetic wave is a wave which is a combination of electric and magnetic fields. Now whenever we are normally going to transmit an electrical signal, what we normally going to transmit? We either transmit a magnetic electric field which we have in the modulator by a magnetic field or by an electric field, and EM wave is been generated by the radiating transmitting antenna. So antenna in fact actually radiates an EM wave. That means the electrical signal is converted into EM wave by a antenna, and that antenna is going to transmit that EM wave through the channel. So that means here all the frequencies that we normally going to have simply comes under the electromagnetic wave frequencies. Now whenever we are intended to transmit a low frequency signal to a longer distance, we have came to know that we are in fact transmitting only a high frequency signal ranging from a lowest value of 30 hertz to a highest value of terahertz. So here we are going to have various types of frequencies normally used in the communication. So here one thing we have to see, or one thing we have to look at, is that we are not transmitting the electrical signal directly in the free space. So many conversions have been taken place. If you just recollect the basic block diagram of a communication system, so every communication system is going to have, first block is going to be information source. Whatever the physical signal which we have will be simply transmitted using the information source to the transmitter section. What the transmitter is normally going to do? Transmitter is going to convert this physical signal, which is in the form of voice, which is in the form of gestures or data, binary data, whatever it is. So that physical signal, usually in analog communications we consider the physical signal as a voice signal. Like now my voice signal is there, I want to transmit my voice signal. So usually the voice signal is taken as the physical signal in the case of the analog communications. Now this voice as it is not transmitted directly into the electromagnetic spectrum. So that is why first of all what we are doing, we have to compulsorily process this voice signal. How do I process the voice signal? By using electronic circuits we have to process the voice signal. To process the voice signal we need a electrical signal, because all the electronic circuits are going to process the electrical signals only. So therefore we have to convert this voice signal into a electrical signal. So first of all, information source, in the block diagram whatever we have information source. Information source is going to radiate the actual message signal, maybe in the form of voice. Then transmitter is going to convert this voice into a electrical signal. after it converts an electrical signal, it is going to modulate. That signal is going to get modulated so that it can be transmitted to the longer distance. Now, after this process called modulation, what will be done? This signal is given to the transmitting antenna. What the transmitting antenna is going to do? Transmitting antenna is going to radiate this particular electrical processed electrical signal or modulated electrical signal into a electromagnetic wave. So this electromagnetic wave is comprising of electric and magnetic fields. So the EM wave is nothing but the child of the electric and magnetic fields. So that means the transmitting antenna is in fact radiating the electromagnetic wave. So and hence we have to understand what are all the various frequency spectrums involved in transmitting a low frequency signal or high frequency signal or any user defined signal. So therefore we have to discuss about the various ranges of frequencies which are involved in the analog communications and other communications as well. So now here what we normally going to have is, yes, so first of all we have one more term that we have to understand here. That term is going to be the wavelength. Now what is wavelength? Wavelength is represented by a symbol lambda. So that lambda is nothing but equal to C by F. This is the general formula for the wavelength of a wave or wavelength of a signal. So what is C is nothing but? C is nothing but the velocity of free space. That means it is written as equal to 3 into 10 power 8 meters pi. What is this F? F is known as the input signal frequency. So this is general formula for wavelength of a signal or wavelength of electromagnetic wave. Signal is basically electrical terminology. Wave is nothing but the signal radiated by an antenna. It is going to be same. Only thing is the form got changed. As far as system is concerned, as far as electronic system is concerned, the electronic system is going to process the signal. As far as antenna is concerned, antenna is going to radiate a wave. But more or less both of them are going to be same for us. Whatever electrical signal we have in the transmitter, that same electrical signal is radiated in the form of EM wave by a transmitting antenna. So therefore the EM wave what we transmit is same as the electrical signal what we have in the transmitter. Both of them are going to be all at the same. So another term which is very important in the case of the electromagnetic spectrum is going to be called as a wavelength. So wavelength is nothing but equal to C by F. What is C? Velocity of light, which is going to be 3 into 10 power 8 meters per meters, and F is nothing but the input signal frequency. So there are few things which are very important, few terminology which are very important as far as the analog communications is concerned. One is going to be the time period which we already know. That means whenever you wanted to observe the waveform, we always observe the waveform in the time domain. We don't observe the waveform in the frequency domain. To analyze the signal, we have to analyze the signal in the frequency domain. That is the reason why we are applying the transform techniques. So that is only the reason why we apply transform techniques, because when we have a time domain, why should we bother about frequency domain? We have so many transforms in the signals and systems called as Fourier transform, Laplace transform, Z transforms. Now what is the purpose of this transform? Using these transforms, we are simply representing the time domain signal in another domain. Okay. So in the case of Fourier transform, we are going to transform the time domain signal into the frequency domain signal so that we can easily analyze that signal in the system. So to perform analysis of the signal, we are doing the transformation technique. So that means that is what one important thing aspect which we have to bother about in the analog communications, because analog communications is an extension of signals and systems. It is an application on the signals and systems. That is why whatever terms which we have come across in the signals and systems, same terms we normally going to come across here also. So therefore the basic knowledge that what we require is the signals and systems and the AEC subject. Once you know these two subjects, you can easily understand the analog communication subject very, very easily. Now we are at writing out the electromagnetic wave spectrum. So what is electromagnetic wave? Just now we discussed an electromagnetic wave contains the range of the electromagnetic wave is nothing but the oscillating electrical signal radiated by a transmitting antenna. And the range of frequency of electromagnetic waves are simply given something like this. Now here we are starting the range with 30, that means number 3. Why this number 3? Because this wavelength is very important parameter for us. This wavelength equation we have C by F. What is C? This 3 into 10 power 8 meters we cannot change. That will be simply everything that should be like that only. 3 into 10 power 8. It cannot be 4 into 10 power 8, 5 into 10 power 8, 6 into 10 power 8. No, that is not the case. So always the velocity of light is going to be 3 into 10 power 8, which we already know. So that means whatever you are simply writing, it is better we write in terms of 3. If you write in terms of 3, then it will be very easy for us to simply remember all this particular spectrum. Even though the spectrum is not very much crisp in its limitations, you can deviate little bit from one to another in the real time applications. But in order to designate, in order to write some notes on a spectrum, we normally going to start with 3. We don't start with 1, 2 or any other number. Why? Because we have to give a relationship with respect to the velocity of light. That is why we are starting with a number 3. Okay, so keep in mind that whenever you are going to write the spectrum equation, we are writing with number 3. Now first of all, we already know that our electrical mains, we have a supply mains. What is the frequency supply mains? We discussed in the rectifiers chapter. That is 50 hertz signal, 230 volts, 50 hertz signal is normally used for our, by our AC mains. So AC mains frequency range is 50 hertz. That means, let us try to use that basic knowledge to use the range. Now here, we are starting with number 3, so therefore we start with 30 to 300 H. Now whenever we write the next limit here, in the range, you simply multiply it by 10. When you multiply it by 10, you get 30 to 300. So therefore, we normally going to keep on getting the various ranges. Now you know between 30 hertz to 300 hertz, we have a 50 hertz. 50 hertz is a power signal. So therefore, this range is going to be a power signal communication range. Okay, now what we have to understand is that whenever you are going to write the range, just simply multiply the lowest one with 10, so that we will be getting the range. So 30 to 300 hertz. The next one is 300 hertz to 3 kilohertz. Then 3 kilohertz to 30 kilohertz. Like that, keep on multiplying it by 10 to get the upper limit in the spectrum. So it is very easy to remember to start with, very easy to remember to write the frequency ranges. Okay. So now 30 to 300 hertz is normally used for what applications? Power signal communication applications. Various countries are going to use various ranges of these low frequencies to transmit their power signals. Okay, so therefore this particular range has been allotted for the power signal communications, and these frequencies are known as extremely low frequencies. That means these frequencies are used only to transmit the power signals, not the actual information signals. So handshaking signals, power signals, all this can be done in this particular frequency range only. So they comes under the extremely low frequencies. Now what is the wavelength of this particular range of frequencies? What is the basic formula for wavelength? Lambda is equal to C by F. C is equal to 3 into 10 power 8 meters per second. So this I can write as 3 into 10 power 8 meters by, what is the frequency that I can write it here? Low frequency, 30 hertz. So I am writing here 30, that means 3 into 10. So this 3 will get cancelled. So it's going to be 10 power 7 here, 10 power 7 meters. So the wavelength of this particular 30 hertz signal is going to be 10 power 7 meters range. So 10 power 7 meters is the wavelength. Now we already know, I already discussed in the previous class, what is a wavelength. Wavelength is the distance travelled by a wave in a unit time, is known as a wavelength. So this is the range now. Now for 300 similarly, what we get now? Simply we divide this by 10, we get a 10 power 6. Now, once again, like that, we normally going to get the ranges for the wavelength. So, this wavelength range you have to calculate in the exam based on this particular formula. And by applying this formula, you will be getting wavelengths for all these various ranges. Now, once you get wavelength for a particular frequency range, other frequency ranges is quite simple, quite easy for us to write in the exam. So, once the question has been asked to write the EM wave spectrum, okay, so therefore I have given this particular EM wave spectrum for you. The next frequency range is 300 hertz to 3 kilohertz. So 300 hertz means what? I can write this as 0.3 kilohertz, 0.3k to 3 kilohertz. This is the voice frequency range. So what is voice frequency? Human voice basically we speak about. So the human voice frequency range is always going to be 0.3 kilohertz to 3 kilohertz. So this is the range of frequencies. And now coming to this wavelength, how do we get the wavelength? Same thing now. What is the last limit? 10 power 6 is this wavelength. What about this? Simply divide this by 10. You get a 10 power 5. So this is the wavelength in meters, 10 power 6 meters to 10 power 5 meters is going to be the range of wavelength for the voice frequencies. And what are the applications of this voice frequencies? Normally use it for intercom communication purpose. What is intercom? It is the wired telephone connection in a particular building. Say there is an office, imagine in the office, say in the college, for example, our ISL college, we have so many departments like EEE, ECE, computer science, and all these departments are placed at different places. So if at all they wanted to communicate each other, what they will do? They are normally going to have intercom telephone connection, wired connection. Using that intercom telephone connection, they are normally going to communicate each other. So that is what the basic application called intercom communication. So this intercom voice communication normally used in this particular frequency range. The next one, next range is going to be, next simply start writing with that now. So the highest one is 3 kilohertz, 3 kilohertz is 30 kilohertz. That's going to be very low frequency range. So this very low frequency range, now similarly we'll be getting the wavelength lambda. So just simply 10 power 5 to divided by 10, we get 10 power 4. This is normally used for submarine communication engineering. That means submarine is normally used in the electronic warfare. Under the ocean. So this is submarine signal frequencies. The next, similarly we just continue now, 30 kilohertz to 300 kilohertz. This is going to be the low frequency range. So this is normally used for telephone and AM broadcast applications. So now similarly I can write it for equation for wavelength. And next frequency range is 300 kilohertz to 3 megahertz. Now this is normally used for AM communications and also the FM communications. Now whenever we go from kilohertz to megahertz, we will be slowly moving towards low frequency range to a high frequency range. Low frequency range to a high frequency range. So this is used for the AM communication. Okay. So after this up to 3 megahertz, we normally call this as a high frequency range. So the megahertz frequency range is nothing but a high frequency range usually. So that is why in the laboratory, if you observe our CRO, conventional dual slope CRO, what is the maximum frequency range printed over there? It is going to be 2 megahertz is the maximum frequency printed over there. That means after 2 megahertz, whatever is normally going to be there will simply comes under a high frequency range of frequencies. So therefore this high frequency is nothing but 3 megahertz to 30 megahertz is known as the high frequency range of frequencies. High frequency range of frequencies. Okay. So now what about the applications of this high frequency range? It's going to be FM application. Basically FM signals are normally transmitted at a megahertz range. At a megahertz range, and a TV communication also is normally going to be done at a megahertz range. Then after that we normally going to have next frequency range 30 megahertz to 300 megahertz. So it's going to be called as very high frequency range, and this frequency range is normally applicable for FM, TV and mobile communication applications. Right, then after this we are going to have 0.3 GHz to 3 GHz. It comes under ultra high frequency ranges. It is also used for mobile communications and some part of microwave communications. So this is normally used applications used for mobile applications and microwave applications. The next frequency range is going to be 3 GHz to 30 GHz. Now this frequency range is used for microwave frequency range. Usually remember, microwave frequency range means 3 GHz to 30 GHz range is the microwave frequency range. It's a very important point to remember. So the most important points are that 3 GHz to 30 GHz, 3 MHz to 300 MHz. These two you have to remember in our analog communication subject, because these two are very important things what we have. So this 3 GHz, 30 GHz ranges comes under the microwave communications. So microwave means what? It's going to be definitely going to be super high frequency range or very high frequency range communication signals. The next one you're going to have is infrared. So 30 GHz, 300 GHz infrared range normally used for radar applications, radar and microwave communication. And just beyond that, up to terahertz, 3 terahertz, we normally going to have optical communications. Now once after we study all these various spectrums, what is that we have to understand? We have to understand that whenever we radiate any signal, we are going to radiate signal in this particular frequency ranges only, because it is going to be electromagnetic wave. Now all this spectrum, what we understand from all this spectrum is that these frequency ranges are the frequency ranges we have to use to modulate our low frequency signal into a high frequency signal. So after you modulate your low frequency into one of the ranges of these frequencies, then it is ready to radiate by a transmitting antenna. So that's what we have to understand from this particular frequency spectrum. Thank you.